Hello, dear subscribers and fellow viewers. Welcome to another edition from me. I am to produce to you in this tutorial a key aspect of the software that you really need to know before the exam tomorrow. You need to know before the software in any office, which is all about. I'm going to show you how to create taxes. All the possible taxes that a company is often subjected to. I'll be showing you the various steps on how to create a tax today. This one is actually coming from the request of Muma Raisa, who said in the channel as a comment, please can you do another one to show us how to record taxes in Sage Sari? That is VAT recording. Precisely, she said she needs VAT recording. She needs a tutorial on VAT recording. Wow. That is so great. That's actually what we're doing right away. I'll be showing us how to create taxes, precisely the VAT, value added tax. That's what she has requested from us. So this is quite an interesting request from her because it's something that students really need to know how to go about it. Before I leave you, I am Milton Munzi, the co-presenter of in this channel, Mumimbi Consulting. I will be drilling you today on this aspect based on the request of this dear student. So, how do you create tax in Sage Sari Accounting 100? Sage Sari Accounting 100, just as any software, is a very sophisticated and complicated program that needs a lot of follow-up and also good mastery before you could manipulate it. So, just like any other aspect of it, taxes are being created, prepared and kept before they're being applied in transaction or in recording transactions. So it's not something that just happens automatically. You really need to prepare yourself for them. And other tax and other deductions that will affect your recording. Remember, taxes have different rates. Company tax has its rate, value added tax has its rate, PIT, excise duty, and all the different taxes you may think of. They have their rate and their own mode of application. And so in order to create them in this system, this is a business software, therefore means it should be able to respect or to perform all the tasks that a business entity is actually is supposed to be subjected under vis-a-vis the OHADA accounting or the OHADA member accounting or the French system of business. However, I will drill you through all that this evening. So in order to start with you, I will start how are taxes created in this software. In order to create tax in this software, you go to structure, you go down, you take on in the list of options or in the window that is displayed, go down, you take on tax rate. In this space that pops up, you right click in it and you take on add new element. You see a second window displayed to you. I could actually arrange them in a way that I'll be able to see when I'm working on them. Let me put them like this to see well everything that every bit of stuff that we're doing there. All right, let us assume that we are about creating a tax, like say VAT invoice or VAT recovery on purchase, but that will affect purchases. Okay, so in this software you have here, in this everything we manipulated in this section and we approved here. So where you have the tax code, you are required to put a code here that you should not repeat it. Take serious note as students, please, this code is not an account number, because as a lecturer, I've witnessed this in class several times, countless times. Students, when they say tax code, instead of writing a code, letters, they need to put account number. That is wrong. However, you could mix words and letters, you could mix figures and letters, it will still go. Because the objective here is that this code should not repeat itself. I can't use a VAT. I use a VAT for VAT on purchase, I will not be able to use another VAT again, a VAT for VAT on sales. So I really need to distinguish it. So I could just write there VAP to stand for VAT on purchase, or I could put a VA1 to stand on to represent this particular, to give it as a code to this VAT, or I could put the VAA, anything that I choose to, but I should make sure that I retain it, and I should also make sure I should never repeat it again. So I'm going to put VAP. Okay. I take on tab key, or I move to the where I have sign. This section here, where I have sign. VAT on purchase is a deductible VAT. It's going to deduce money from my pocket when my deductible. If you press on this one, you're going to see two stuff there. You have the deductible and collected. So we'll explain the two together. So I'm going to validate if it was a VAT on sales. I'll probably taking on collected because we collect money from our customers. But since it's on sales, we will giving out money, we'll bring money from our coffer to some other people out there. So we're going to take on deductible. A level of name, I'll click there, right? I give a name. Please, this name I give it should never repeat itself in creating another tax. All right, for example, you write a VAT on purchase. Oh my goodness, I've written it in CapLock. Very important for this software. Writing CapLock is very important in this software. But on purchase. Okay, that could be enough for me, provided I'll not use the same name again. But on purchase, so I take on tab key. Oh, where I have the tax account. Great job. The tax account now is an account number that I am going to put to represent this VAT. VAT on purchase always 4452. I take on tab key. Tell my account number. I could actually press on this drop down arrow here to select in my chart of account if I thought it already exists there. But it's not really advisable at all to create a tax account number in the chart of account before using it in this section. The reason I'm going to show you very soon is it creates a lot of chaos in your work if you go by that method. So it's always advisable, let the account number, it shouldn't enter in your chart of account database first. You come and do it here, they'll take you to to your chart of account later for you to create there, and then you're going to do a lot of beautiful work. So now I'm going to take on 4452 and move on to tab key, or go to this. So we have tax type. You have the VAT debit. There are so many sections. You have VAT debit, VAT collector, and so many others. So I'm taking VAT debit. Why? Because purchases are expenses. Expenses mean, therefore, that in our journal, we always debit expenses. All expenses are debited. Therefore, mean this VAT is an expense to us. It should as well be debited. That's why you see that I'll take on VAT debit. That VAT debit simply means that you should debit this entry in my journal. So I take on tab key. Yeah, have rate. What is the rate? Is it in rate? You could have a tax in rate, you have a tax in amount or in quantity. So we could use all these things today to have a better understanding. In our subsequent video, we'll see how we could use all of them, how to create VAT in amount and stuff like that. Okay, so I've selected on rate. What is the rate for VAT on purchase? It is VAT in Cameroon is 19.25. I'll enter it there. I should model myself a percentage sign because it's already the percentage sign here, so I don't need that again. When I've entered the rate here, 19.25 here like this, what you need to do now, don't take it on tab key. You take your mouse to this section where you have number. Click on the number, press on who here. They'll project you your travel account database. You should select on the account number for purchase of goods, which is 601, signing for purchase of goods. After having selected on that, you need to take on the click on enter, the enter key on your keyboard. You click on enter like this. They'll tell you, they explain to you that general account 4452 not existing in your chart of account. Do you want to create it? Take years. That's why I said that wasn't really advisable yet to create it before getting here. That is the message I'm saying to you. So they're going to take you now onto your chart of account database. As you take on here, they take you now, they give you this new page now. This is a very, very sensitive page. Make sure you students always make sure you have this page while you're creating a VAT. If you don't have this page, there's going to be a very big challenge when you're recording the VAT. As I'm telling you, the VAT may not be able to appear automatically. So, okay. So this is my VAT here. In this section where I have the, where it's painted blue, where I have name, you copy this name here, VAT on purchase. I copy name there, VAT on purchase. VAT on purchase. I move, I use my mouse again. For my, I carry my cursor to a level where I have tax code. A little task code, I select this code here, VAP. Make sure I press on home and select on this code here. I press on home, but this is the first one, of course. Only one is there, so it's already there. Okay, now, if these two things are not done properly, this will not appear automatically, especially this one here. This will not appear automatically. So please, I beg of you, make sure you select on this task code here and enter this name here. After you are done, don't take on enter. Wrong. Close this page from here, because why you click on close like this, a message will appear to you that general account 4452 not match with the VAT. on purchase. Do you want to match it? Say yes. If you take on the option yes, you notice that it will move up automatically and appear inside this section here, 4452, which stands for VAT on purchase. At this level now, if you take on enter key on your keyboard, the 4452 and 601 will enter and pair up themselves in this session. This is a message to tell you that wherever 601 will go, 4452 will follow. Very important. So at this stage now, you're done creating your VAT. You simply go and you press the control key on your keyboard and the J button to validate it on this section. Control plus J. Control plus J would make it go to this section. Very important. Wow, beautiful. That's how you can create a VAT on purchase. That's the first thing. Yeah, we're just going to do just two. I'm also going to create a VAT on sales. So that should affect my boat journal. VAT on sales, I take on. How to create a VAT on sales? I'll start back on the tax code. The tax code again, now VAS. We'll use VAS. Yeah, VAS. After I've entered the code, which is not an account number, I repeat that again. I move to this section where I have sign. Now, instead of taking on deductible, I'll press on this drop-down arrow, I hold on it, I select on collected. Why collected? As we'll be selling goods, this is a VAT invoice on sale. As we'll be selling goods, we'll collect this money on behalf of the state from our clients and our, in fact, from our consumers. Okay, so now, after having taken on this, I move where you have name, I enter the name. The name now is VAT in VAT invoice on sales. As for the whole accounting plan, VAT invoice on sales. Okay, I move up now. We have the tax account, which the mean the account number. I said again, it could actually be found here, but for me, I don't really love putting it there before this time for the purpose that I've explained to you a moment ago. So I'll choose to type it. 4431 is the account number for VAT on sales. I move up now to tax type here. Tax type. This VAT is not debited, so I really need to click here and select on collection. There's a key, there's a strategy on how to master this thing. Remember, here we took collection and here is collected. So in order to know that you're actually right track, when I take a collected, here should be collection. When I take deductible, here should be VAT debit. So in this case, I've taken on collected. Yeah, should also be collection. Now I take on tab key, remove this section. It is my VAT, is it in rate, in amount, or in quantity? It's in rate. I move ahead. Okay, now in rate, and I have to enter the rate here. The rate is still the same in Cameroon. VAT rate is 19.25%. I could still repeat that rate here, it doesn't pose a problem. 19.25%. When I'm done typing here, I move down to where I have number. I press and hold the drop-down arrow. I select now on the account number for sales of which is 701. I because when I click here, they're going to project to me my type of account database. I select 701 there. Why I have selected 701 now? I should take on enter on the keyboard. Click on the enter button on your keyboard. And if you do so, this message will still appear telling you that this account number is not existing type of account database. I told you some time ago in some other videos that if a an account number is not found in your travel account database, not identified, that your system will not allow you to use and recognize this. That this is a typical message as coming from such complaint. So you see, they say it's not there. Do I want to create it? I say yes. I take on yes. They will give me this page again, a very important page, very, very important. Take note of everything I'm doing there. I just repeat this same name the same way. If you don't repeat the same way, this file will not appear automatically, please. The same spelling, the same. If I made an error, if you have any misspelled word here, you repeat the same thing here. If not, this VAT will not be able to appear automatically. So just write there VAT invoice on sales. VAT invoice on sales. I move now to this section for tax code. I press now. I select on this VAS. I press on this. I select on VAS. I am done. Wow. So if I'm done, I'll close this page. I just click here. They say general account 431 not match with tax VAT invoice on sales. Do I want to match it? I say yes. I've matched it. Wow. So when I say yes, it will move up automatically and this page becomes closed. At this juncture now, I could press on the enter key on my keyboard. Press on enter key on my keyboard. Now, so that the two to enter in this same room is like kind of the two people now that have married that together. Anyway, one person go, you always see the other. So that is that. At this juncture now, I just simply click on the, I press the control key on my keyboard, press the J button to have it validated. Wow. Now, this is done. That's how you could create a tax in Social Security Accounting 100. I'm going to go now into recording. But you see how this tax will appear automatically on my journals when I'm recording. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope you did enjoy it. Please, if you actually enjoy it, click on the subscribe button. Share the link with other students elsewhere, with other consumers elsewhere. Remember, this thing is actually there to help you students, lecturers, and professionals that have some difficulty in this program. If you really see it interesting, please, I just want to click on the thumb up button that is there, which means the like button. Click on that like button. And remember to share the link with some other students elsewhere that you know they need the knowledge, with some other people that need the knowledge. Remember, this is Social Security Accounting 100 in English. What a rare privilege. It's actually been so difficult to have this tutorial of this nature in English language. So I'm just there to assist you. To encourage the work, click on the thumb up button, the like button, comment, and share. Drop all your worries. Remember, today it is thanks to Muma Raisa that we are doing this one. So we pray that other students will drop theirs also for us to do the beautiful tutorial. We are there for you and your service and everything. Thanks a lot for watching. See you next in the next tutorial.